I hate spiders. I really, truly hate spiders. And if there's anything worse than spiders, it's giant spiders that have a taste for human flesh. Now I know they can be misunderstood creatures, but there's not a chance, not a single chance, that Acromantulas fall into that category. Guys, they are absolutely terrifying. And as a matter of fact, Acromantulas are my least favourite creature in the entire Harry Potter series, but at the same time, they are so interesting to read about. What's also fascinating is the history behind them, how they operate, and the story of their most notable being, Aragog, is a tale that's definitely worth telling. So, everyone, if you haven't guessed by now, that's exactly what I'm going to do in today's video. I'm going to take you all through the history of Acromantulas in the Wizarding World, and I'm going to tell you the origin story of Aragog. So, with that being said, welcome back to the world of Harry Potter, and please enjoy today's video. Okay everyone, so as I've said, we'll start with the history of Acromantulas as a species, and then we move on to the story of Aragog. Now, while there are rather large spiders in the world, the Acromantula is the largest, but it's not gotten that way naturally. The species was created from magical experimental breeding several centuries ago, and has been reported to have been seen as early as 1794. Experimental breeding has seen the creation of extremely dangerous beasts such as basilisks and cockatrices, yet it has given the world beautiful creatures such as the hippogriff, so the opinion on experimental breeding varies even before the ban on the practice was introduced as recently as 1965. The Acromantula are, as many of you may have guessed, not native to the Dark Forest or even to the country of Scotland. They're not even native to the continent of Europe. You see, the creature first originated out of Southeast Asia, most notably Borneo, which is located close to the Philippine Islands. Its preferred habitat is dense jungles, so it's no surprise that they settled so well in the Dark Forest beside Hogwarts. Acromantulas have 8 black eyes, which turned white if blind, and were typically covered in thick black hair. They have a leg span that can reach up to 15 feet. According to Pottermore, on average, Acromantulas were the size of a cart horse, though older specimens may grow even longer than 15 feet in leg span. They possessed a set of giant pedipalps, which they used to eat live prey, or their own dead kin. It's most likely that they do eat as smaller spiders do, entangling their prey in an unescapable web and drinking their blood and bodily fluids. Some spiders are known to inject an enzyme into their prey after drinking the blood, in order to liquefy the remaining flesh for consumption, which is why there may have been references in the books, Aragog in particular, of Acromantulas noted to be craving human meat. Their pincers produced a clicking sound when they were agitated or excited, and they also secreted poison when excited. They are sentient creatures, and capable of human speech. It has also been questioned if they are in any way telekinetic, as the leader of the colony has a direct communication line to each and every spider, being able to control them at will. Acromantula fangs contained a highly toxic venom, valued at 100 galleons a pint as early as 1996. We see Professor Slughorn retrieve some venom purely for academic purposes, a recurring excuse for his acquiring of things that he knows he really shouldn't acquire. When it comes to reproduction, the female was usually larger than the male, and can lay up to 100 soft, wide, beach ball sized eggs at a time. They usually hatched in 6 to 8 weeks, but in some cases it took longer. Any eggs that didn't hatch were eaten by the newborns. Acromantula eggs were a Class A non-tradable good. However, we know dear old Hagrid liked to break the law in order to shelter animals and give them a better life, so is it any surprise that one ended up at Hogwarts? Now, although Acromantulas are basically giant spiders if we simplify it, they did have several differences. Now, the biggest difference was their social behaviour. Unlike smaller spiders, Acromantulas were quite social. They lived in large colonies consisting of hundreds of their species. These colonies were led by the oldest male and oldest female, who were highly respected and met with absolute obedience. Aragog, as I mentioned earlier, was able to keep his entire colony from eating Hagrid, despite their instincts telling them to attack the half-giant, solely because he respected Hagrid as a friend. So this also shows that the spiders were able to form friendships with other species, depending on how well they were raised, and most importantly, by choice. However, the line of friendship began and ended with that person alone. It did not stretch to any others associated with the said person, meaning, if you became friends with an Acromantula, it doesn't mean they wouldn't feast on your sibling or child, for example. The species didn't fear much, and were actually quite aggressive, but their most beneficial asset in almost all situations actually made them very vulnerable against their biggest foe. Having so many eyes allowed the spiders to see from all directions, meaning they are always ready should they be attacked. Although I can't imagine many who'd want to attack one of those things. Yet when it comes to their natural enemy, the basilisk, their numerous eyes present them with a massive disadvantage. For one glance, one stare, even momentarily into a basilisk's eyes, means instant death for the creatures. Don't forget everyone, Acromantulas cannot close their eyes to protect themselves either, as they have no eyelids. For these reasons, Acromantulas fear the basilisk like no other. It does make me wonder, however, how Aragog came to know and actually fear the basilisk, as he's never seen one, unless he learned of the story while part of his original colony before he came to Hogwarts, though he would have been very young at the time. Now, as many of you know, or will know, as I've mentioned his name several times within this video, there is a resident Acromantula at Hogwarts, well, the Dark Forest specifically, and he goes by the name of Aragog. Now, Aragog was brought to Britain sometime within the year 1942. He was acquired by Rubeus Hagrid as just a newborn, and surprisingly, while Hagrid was still a student at Hogwarts. The half-giant illegally kept the spider on the school premises, feeding it scraps and making sure it was cared for. This lasted for several months until Tom Riddle, needing someone to take the fall for Myrtle Warren's murder in order to keep the school from closing, framed Hagrid and Aragog for the girl's murder, which seen Hagrid expelled and Aragog driven out of the school and into the Dark Forest, where he remained for over 50 years. With Hagrid being kept on as gamekeeper at Hogwarts after his wrongful but upheld expulsion, he regularly visited Aragog, bringing him food. He eventually organised a second female Acromantula to be brought into the country. Mossag then became Aragog's mate, and the two spiders created a huge colony together, something they were extremely grateful to Hagrid for his assisting with. Now, it's unknown how Hagrid felt, if he was angry or upset with Aragog for allowing his sons and daughters to attack and attempt to feast on Harry and Ron when they visited the Acromantula colony in 1992 at Hagrid's suggestion. It's a situation that I would have really liked to see an outcome with, as such a clash between the half-giant and the spider friend would have been interesting to see become resolved, especially as Aragog could in no way appear to seem weak or yielding before his offspring or his wife. In 1996, Aragog contracted an unknown illness over the summer, and despite Hagrid's attempts to heal and comfort the spider by feeding him giant grubs, he eventually died on April 20th, 1997. Before this time, it had been dangerous for Hagrid to go and visit Aragog because, sensing the giant spider's weakness, his family was getting rather restive and possibly preparing to devour him. When Aragog died, Hagrid was able to get the spider's corpse out of the colony before his children could attempt to cannibalize the corpse, though barely, as they would no longer hold back in an attempt to devour Hagrid. Aragog was buried in a deep pit near Hagrid's house the very next evening.
Thank you so much for watching. I truly, truly appreciate your support. Everyone, notifications of uploads are more important than ever. So please, if you haven't already, turn those notifications on to make sure you're notified the moment my video goes live. Making videos is what I love to do. It's my dream and my passion. However, it does cost time and money to produce this content. So if you have a dollar to spare to support me on Patreon in exchange for some exclusive unseen content, then you can click the Patreon link below or at the end of this video. Please only support me if you can afford it. And make sure to follow me on Instagram at InstaDNJ and on Twitter at PotterFolklore. Check out my other videos appearing on screen, and please make sure, most importantly, to hit that subscribe button. Thanks again, everyone, and please have a great day.